see. Hi, Brook.
That was a lovely little improvised guy. I know.
Do you know what? It wasn't improvised, actually.
That's really well rehearsed, unfortunately.
Yeah. For about an hour beforehand, Kelly, at Skyride last year, on the mount, I thought, brilliant. And I went to him and said, come on.
He grabbed my hand and started kicking
about it.
I completely forgot. I didn't know what he was doing. And then I figured it. And he's like, we have to do it today. Yeah. Again.
Well, that's a brilliant way of saying it. Now, you're actually here to talk about. And so, what is it?
There are events all across the country. And you can basically come and ride your bike around a traffic-free city. So it's a fantastic day. And I took part in the one in London last year. And you did. What did you
do? Well, Kelly, I did Manchester to Kelly at the Mall, who was looking beautiful in a dress. And she was.
And I just went around the block. Yeah.
Oh my god, how did you win something?
Yeah, it was about 1,000 kilometres or out in the thousands, come wind or rain. got a geography degree.
I think something like that, I always thought, well, that's for people that are keen cyclists, but actually it's not at all, and I think that's why I got involved, because they kind of want to show that it's for everyone. You know, there were little kids there were glamorous girls on, like, Pashley bikes looking really stylish, and so this year we've just taken it to the next level, and I'm writing a fashion blog with Erin O'Connor and Kate Halfpenny, so we're kind of encouraging
girls.
Fashion
blog? You mean stylish on the bike? Speech.
No, none of that.
Like, we're used to Lycrafin. That's not a problem, you know.
Well, obviously, you're doing Strictly. You mean?
Well, Kate Halfpenny designed some amazing outfits for us, and we just did a big photo shoot. And it's just basically just to encourage girls to look. There we go. That wasn't one of the pictures.
That's
a really lovely bike. Because I said, when I got involved, I was like, you have to get me a Pashley, because I love those old-fashioned bikes.
That's a proper sit-up-and-beg bike, isn't it?
Honestly, that's how good I looked after my 1,000 kilometres.
Yeah, I would recommend wearing high heels.
That dress, is that a cycling dress, then?
Well, I rocked up in just what I would wear on my bike, and everyone was like, you sure you're going to wear that? And I'm like, well, yeah, why not? If I'm at home and I want to go to the shop...
6-foot shoes on?
Not with high heels. I took it up a notch. Any pumps, but... yeah, so it's just really too.
So you just like to get on the naughty about it.
Well, yeah. Family, got friends all coming along to these events. So 12 to plan a route. And then from then on, there's 10 celebrities all together. You've got Gavin Henry, Amy.
My friend Susie Amy,
Kelly,
who I'm rooting for.
Michelle, you know them all, don't you? Some of them were, some of them weren't.
Where were you?
Oh, I know.
I was kind of following.
Because depending on the challenge. She's got her new movie out. And it's called, well, we're about to see you in 3D, which is very exciting. Of course, it should be 3DD, but that's... and the film is...
Don't look.
The film is called Piranha. It sums up...
Yeah. Hopefully it's going to be better than it sounds.
No.
But it's a remake of a cult classic from the 70s. And it stars Richard Dreyfuss, Elizabeth Shue. So I got to work with some really great people. And we filmed in Arizona, which was fantastic. And, I spend the whole film kind of prancing around on a boat in a bikini and making out with girls underwater in 3D. So I know this is 5 o'clock. But it's all for teenage boys.
A teenage boy film.
It's really lots of boobs, lots of blood.
Yeah.
And not much else, really. It's not really apologising for what it is.
Let's have a little.
Take it off!
How close did you get to an action?
I don't want to spoil it, but all the piranhas were basically scuba divers with long green gloves on trying to pull me under the water. So that's basically what it was, because it's all on green screen. So we had to use our imagination, but it was so much fun. I mean, those things are always a good laugh
to do. Well, there must have been some starring piranhas who were real, surely, or else they'd go to equity and complain.
but that's what the director wanted. He wanted to make... You can't really tell from the trailer, but some of the piranhas do have their own characteristics that you recognise.
so you know.
Really the stars of the movie. Yes.
Yes, the nice... It's a Kelly, isn't it?
A Hermes.
A Hermes Kelly.
Yes.
Yeah. He had a good night out. And suddenly thought, oh dear, and you opened your house.
No.
It was either that or the back of the taxi, and I felt bad. I'd had a night out with a friend of mine, and she's from Russia, and so she was pouring vodka that just was going down very easily. I thought it was like water, and I didn't realise until I got outside and the cold air hit me how it affected me, and I got in the back of a taxi, and I thought, oh my goodness, I don't think I can. Oh dear. Oh dear. And then, yeah, I ruined my handbag. So I had to get my friend.
Anna Chapman, her friend was.
To take it to take it back to the shop and send it away to get it cleaned. I was too embarrassed. I was just saving my nephew. was sick in it or something. I don't know. It was condensed milk. It was horrible. It was so awful.
But it's come back.
Never get rid of that handbag. You joking? It's not my favourite handbag.
Oh. That's not good. That's not guessing. Thank you both very much indeed.
Thank you.
And for. Very nice to see you, and it's your birthday today. So happy birthday!
Thank you.
You were, and I will say you were.